debts, but not simply to be its mouthpiece, as many others have been, to hold to a middle way. Spending 30 years of your life attempting to comprehend what had taken place in four. Whilst not breathing a word about this, it was a secret. Picks Jung's elaboration of personal mythology, of a personal cosmology. This is not Jung's science, but it forms its foundation in bedrock, and the science is ultimately folded back into it. It takes its meaning from this personal cosmology. These run like two parallel streams. Neither is reducible to the other. There is no one-to-one translation. And he works along on them. Side by side. three stages of a work which we have, which would illuminate its genesis, but nothing other than that. But this is not the case. So much in this work did not find its way into Jung science. This is a record of an event that made that science possible. For the first time, one can retrace the steps from Jung's fantasies, his reflections upon them, his differentiation of the voices, his attempt to understand himself, and how this became melded together with his scholarship and learning, and led him to forge and mint new psychological concepts. By 1914, you had already established the main terms of what one could call his structural psychology. He had a notion of psychic energy that was non-sexual. He developed the idea of the feeling, emotionally stressed complexes, psychological types of introversion and extroversion, and of the personalities of the introvert and the extrovert. He developed the notion that there was a phylogenetic inherited layer of the unconscious, which consisted of primordial images that would later turn archetypes. The dreams were not merely mystery, but indicated